Alright, so now that our sphere is made, we're going to go ahead and make a cylinder. So we're going to be learning some new tools for this one. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new layer. And this little eyeball here, I don't need this sphere here right now. So I'm going to click this layer and I'm going to click the eyeball. And that just hides it for the time being. It doesn't delete it, it just hides it. So now when I go to this to make my cylinder, we're going to be using quite a few different shapes to do this. So I'm going to go over here to the shape tool, and I'm going to find the one that says ellipse. That's kind of like an oval. And I'm going to go ahead and change my colors this time to a blue color. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to make a shape for the bottom of my cylinder. So here's my shape here. Now, in order to make any edits on this, I want to go ahead and rasterize this layer. Something else you need to do is make sure that you are labeling these. So I'm going to start by doing cylinder one. All right, now I want this same exact shape up at the top. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this by right-clicking or control-clicking, and I'm going to duplicate layer and just go ahead and press OK. Now when you go up here to the move tool, that exact thing is duplicated. Now you see how I have these pink lines here? You might have to turn those on. But that tells you if something's in line. So if I put it over here, you can say that it's not in line. But over here, that tells me that they're stacked right on top of each other. So to make sure that those are on, you can go to View, Show, and Smart Guides. Okay, so I just turned mine off, and I don't see that anymore. So make sure you go View, Show, Smart Guides, and there you'll have that. Okay, now. This shape is not, the cylinder is not finished yet. I have to do two more things, and that's simply by using the line tool. So I'm going to go here, and I want to, you probably want to zoom in for this part, okay? And I'm just going to draw a line that goes, and my line's kind of thick here. So I know it's straight because of that pink line. So I am making sure that this blue line is connecting to both of these ellipses. Now, if you don't, you can change the thickness of this by changing the pixels here. So if I change it to 3 this time, look how much thinner this side will be. So I go ahead and just drag down like that, okay? Now, I'm gonna rasterize both of these layers. Now, as I go to do that, all of these pieces are separate, and I need them to be one big shape. So we are going to learn how to merge layers. And to do that, you are just going to click one of the layers to start with. So I'm going to start here with cylinder one. I'm going to hold down shift on my keyboard, and I'm going to come all the way up here and now click. All four of those are highlighted because those are the four layers that I want to merge together. Then I can right-click or control-click by clicking in the empty blue space, not over any of the words. And there is an option to merge the layers. So now I'm going to go ahead, merge layers. And now this has become one big shape. So let's go ahead and make sure that you name that cylinder. This will get really confusing if you're not merging your layers together. So that's why I'm showing you these videos one shape at a time. So now you can go in and fill in the rest of that. Now, what will happen if you don't have, I'm gonna find, if you have an empty space in here where the line doesn't connect to here, it's gonna go, it's not, the shape's not gonna fill in, okay? So you gotta make sure that everything is touching. Now, and we'll talk about that later in the next form as well. So now I'm going to show you this just real quick. I want to go ahead and have the same type of light source that my sphere here has. Okay, so the light's going to be coming from this way. So I'm going to show you how we can do that. So here, the light space is on this side. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start with some of that white again. So the brush tool here. Now I'm going to go do the same thing so I don't go outside the lines by selecting the background, then going select inverse. So go to the brush tool, and then I'm going to go ahead and start by adding some of this white over here. Now notice I do it to the bottom, but I didn't do it to the top because we don't actually see this part back here. So I want kind of the main thing to be this light blue color. So I'm going to go ahead and just fill in a little bit here. And then I'm going to use the blue tool for my dark shadow color. So I'm going to add more of this over here. Okay. Now, I am going to use that mixer brush tool to blend together, okay? So really kind of blend that together to make sure you have kind of that realistic. Now notice I'm going in this curve shape, not going straight up and down. I'm following this curve of the oval. So when I want the blue to mix over, I have to pull the colors from this side here. So you guys will have to kind of work on making things look a little bit more realistic as far as your blending goes. You can try changing the different brushes too to do that. Some are going to work a little bit better for blending. So you are free to kind of work with that. Mine's a little fuzzy right now. I also usually like to work with a smaller brush. But you can kind of see how this will start to maybe add a little bit of some form to it. I am not going to finish this entire thing because I want you guys to have time to work, and you guys don't need to watch me finish this to understand how to do it. You can go look back at the example. So now, notice I haven't done anything to this top part right here because we want this top part to stay, okay? We want it to look different than this bottom half down here, so we're going to shade it a little bit differently. We're not going to have quite as much light on it, depending on where your light source is. But I'm going to go back to kind of this color here. I'm going to take my brush tool. I'm just going to fill in a little bit here. And I'm going to shade this a little bit different. Now, if I didn't want this to get in here, what I can do, I should have done before, I'm going to go ahead and undo that. I'm going to Command-D. I'm going to take my quick selection tool. And this only pretty much gets around this area here. I'm going to press down shift to kind of pick up a little bit more of that. But what you can also do, you can come up here to this marquee tool. This is a little harder to do. But you can try to draw the oval shape over top to fix. The only problem with this is that if you don't get it right, it's going to move like this. So a good way if you want to use that oval shape tool, is to start a new layer and draw that oval tool over top in a blank layer to kind of the same type of shape, and then just move it. Oh, it's not going to let me do that with this one. So if it's not perfect like how mine was before, just go ahead and you can use the lasso tool to go around it, but I'm just going to go ahead and do the best I can with this here. Okay, so a little bit of shading by putting this here, mixer brush tool. Okay, and so I want this top part to look different, a little different than the bottom, so it's a little darker. Command D, and we can kind of get that oval shape there. Okay, so that's how you make a cylinder.